First dibs. Yeah, it works. Good morning. Good morning and welcome. I guess this is our first episode to a new journey. Today we're going to take a look at alpha clones. And I will go Minmitar.
Once a thriving tribal civilization, the Minmitar were enslaved by the Amar Empire for hundreds of years. Most were freed after a great rebellion, but only at a tremendous cost. Today, the Minmitar Republic is a strong, resurgent nation, determined to win back the glory of its past.
Whoa. Whoa. Let's go. Male or female? That is a question. Sebiestor, Verokir, or Brutor? Can we learn a little bit about them? Widely respected as some of the cluster's most innovative thinkers, Sebiestor are an ingenious people with a natural fondness for engineering. For the last millennium, they have pioneered advances in applied sciences. Despite laboring under chronic material shortages, masters of deriving solutions from impossible circumstances, Sebiestor engineers believe they can build anything with anything out of anything. That's cool. Verokir. Originally nomads in Mitar's vast and inhospitable desert regions, the Verokir are among the most diverse individuals of the Republic. They can be found in professions ranging from doctors to mystics, scholars to merchants. Their quiet work ethic and widespread family clans allow them unlimited social mobility in the Republic, with access to both the best and the worst that society has to offer. Ooh. A martial, strong-willed people, the Brutor hold their tribal heritage close to their hearts and are renowned for living regimented, disciplined lives. Despite presenting a tough, no-nonsense exterior, they are deeply introspective, aware of even the smallest details at all times. Immersed in ancient material, in ancient martial traditions that begin at childhood, they are physically robust individuals and intimidating to face in the flesh. Interesting. I think I'm going to go with the Verokir, the nomads. We're going to make him a boy. Let's go with boy. And... whoa. Shape. Not so muscular. Maybe a little heavy set. A little bit darker in skin here. Can't be so pasty all the time. Yellow. Now we're not going to go the Asian route. We're going to kind of go in the mid-range. Be a little older. Midlife. Huh? Okay, that's fine. Freckles. No freckles. Do we have any scarring? Like pimple scars? No, I don't really pick. Maybe a little bit from wear and tear. Ew. Tiny pupils? No, I usually have jamungus pupils. Change my eye color. We'll go with some orangey tinty there. Let's get some hairstyles. Schwing! Oh man, the Elvis. Still popular in the future. I will go with something else, maybe. Let's just take a look. Oh, it doesn't really let you scroll. Anyways. This is interesting. I've been playing the same characters for so long that I don't even know. I will go with that. We'll go with some less Spocky eyebrows. Spock's eyebrows are great, but it's just, it's not doing it for me on this guy. Get a little beard, a little beard action. He is one ugly motherfucker. Just looks pursy and mad. Why are you so mad? Let's put a little. No, I don't think I can adjust his smile yet. Oh my god. Let's make him alien-like, I guess. I know, this is so irrelevant to the rest of the game. Such interesting that Eve has this robust, like, custom character creation shit. But it plays, like, no role whatsoever in... Oh, what did I... Yeah, it did both sides, okay. Maybe a skinny dude, a skinny, creepy ass dude. Ooh, whoa. Yeah, you can make some weird ass looking guys. But he's an older guy. He's been through some shit. Maybe he's got a weird goatee. Yeah, maybe he's weird about it. He's got a big old chin. Little old chin. Big old chin? Little old chin. He's Minmatar, so he's been through some shit. His family is... His family were slaves. So he... I don't know. What kind of generation? Is he new generation? He's older. We'll say he went for Capsuleer. Can't be that much older. Eye details? The fuck? What does that even do? Eyeliner? Oh. No. Let's take that out. No thanks. Cheek color, lip tone, clothes. Okay. Let's get a jacket that we like. It's kind of a nice jacket. A little cream. A little cream colored. We have other colors of the same jacket? No, it's just a different jacket. There's another color to that. I do like this one though. Get a shirt, because it's fucking cold in space. Do we need to match? No, we don't really give a fuck. We're gonna go with our undies. Let's put some pants on. Put some pants on. These look like tough pants. Like, you could shoot them. Oh, maybe not in the back. It looks like the front has plates. Interesting. Feet. Some boots. Space boots. There are variations. Okay, we got some like buckly boots, more cowboy-esque. Not really digging the buckles. I like the first one. Whatever. Let's go. Eyewear? No, don't need a fucking eyewear. Body modifications. Piercings. No, maybe a head tattoo. He's Minmatar. Make a scary and shit. He went from being a normal guy to being a crazy fucking Minmatar tattooing his face. He looks fucking crazy. Like, he looks like he is a crazy person. Tattoos are intense, man. Wow, this one's pretty cool. Dude, he looks like he would fuck you up. Now he's got a beard. A tattoo over a beard. No, I like the one. I saw one that I liked. This one. Yeah, he looks absolutely fucking crazy. He'll never have any friends, ever. It's over. Friendships, family relations. Nah, you fucked up. But I like it. No augmentations. Just gonna get a weird, creepy picture from the bottom. Oh, this is where you can kind of like adjust things. So I can kind of make him smile, maybe? Oh my god, his smile is weird. No, I don't like the smile. It was just made it so uncomfortable all of a sudden. He's angry. He's been through too much. He's got a fucking grimace and a half. He doesn't like taking pictures, so he just stands there. But his eyeballs, always watching you. Or always watching something. Or always watching his shoes. Or always... What are you doing? He doesn't like pictures. So he looks down. Can never get him to look up. Is that the picture? It's kind of weird. Go back. Am I happy with this? Is he blinking or something? He looks sad. Why does he look so sad? Don't be emo. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Just the way his tattoo works. Shit, that looks awesome. Yeah, keeping it. Keeping it! Who are you? A drifter? Choose your ancestry. Drawing inspiration from their nomadic ancestry, wanderlust runs strong with many Verokir. While many curb their thirst for adventure, there are those who simply cannot settle down in one place for long. Never at rest, they will always be lured by the horizon as their places to see and riches to be discovered. That sounds about right. What school did I go to? The military? For a long time, the bastard child of the Minotaur education system, it existed because it was perceived as needed. It had no support. Let's do it. Fucked up military school. And who is this person? This is Joustica. Name is unavailable. How is that name unavailable? Who the fuck used my name? Oh my god. That can't be Joustica. That don't make no sense. I need a last name. I don't want a last name. Fuck. Let's create something. A Kunst, oops. Is good. A Kunst has been created. Here we go. Wish us luck.
Calling any convoy Talon Alpha 5 survivors. Come in, all survivors. Tracking an active training corvette. What is your status? Recruit, wake up and respond.
I'm here. Hi. Wait.
Recruit, do you remember anything from the attack? Did you see the drifter swarm warp in and gut your fleet?
No, I...
Feel panic and fear as ships burned all around you. I imagine you remember at least that. Well, keep a lid on that for now. Recruit, my name is Fleet Commander Vidari, and from this point on, you will consider me your commanding officer. Now, we need to figure this situation out. I'm lifting your training restrictions and giving you access to your ship's onboard AI. This is Aura, a powerful ally. She'll help you get your ship moving.
What? I'm trying to understand what I'm looking at.
I am Aura. will assist you in commanding your vessel and navigating New Eden. My core logic library has been proven to increase the odds of survival by several orders of magnitude. But I am only capable of advising you.
Where am
I? You must make decisions for yourself. Simulations have proven that situational awareness is key to survival. I will now demonstrate how to become aware and alert. Captain, if you close my comms window for any reason, you will be able to recall it through the operations info panel by clicking Aura Tips. When you're ready to continue, click Next.
This is really nice. The audio tutorial.
The view around your ship. Hold down the left mouse button and move the mouse
around. Whoa, where am I? Whoa. I'm in a field. I'm also in a graveyard.
Let's test basic navigation functions.
Double clicking. Sorry, I did it too fast.
To stop your ship, you should click the hyperspeed stop button.
Stop.
Using these functions will help you explore the sun.
Oh.
What in the name? Are you serious? My logs are saying you haven't even graduated from the Academy Flight School yet.
Sorry.
Okay, we'll make this work even if you're all I've got. You're gonna have to start right now. My scans are showing more life signs near your location. Your convoy included transports with important research scientists. Given their work, if they were to be picked up by drifter scavengers, it would be a nightmare for the Republic. So check the wrecks for potential survivors.
There's Rex. Ooh, Rex.
Captain.
I got you. Sorry, bitch. I don't know why I'm zipping through it. I want to hear her talk.
Their cargo hold to your own. Move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents, and then press the Loot All button.
Oh yeah, I just did that. That's cool. Oh my god, I love this, like, interactive menu shit. What the fuck? This is a thing?
After you have clicked the Loot All button, you should close the inventory window using the X in the corner. I'm receiving signals that indicate the next survivor is located in the highlighted wreckage. Right-click on the wreckage and select Approach. To transfer the next survivor to your ship, you should repeat the same steps as before.
You got it, Mama.
Move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents and then press the Loot All button. Excellent, Captain. My scanners indicate one more survivor. Approach the highlighted wreckage. You should now transfer the last survivors to your ship. Don't forget to close the inventory windows after you have finished.
Got it, Mama. This is really cool. I just hit 100 million skill points in Eve. And I don't know, this is very interesting to start over. Scientist.
Captain, I am Professor Tannen from the Sisters of Eve research team. Thank you for saving my life. The attack was complete carnage. Thousands were killed. Our research on drifter strikes indicates they will likely return to this location to retrieve any survivors.
Rex look pretty cool, but I don't get what this is.
I believe the drifters.
All this, like, cause it's just debris.
Information extraction is very invasive. Such information is classified and of great value to the Empire, but since my survival depends on you, I am entrusting you with this.
Recruit, I thought you'd be a cloud of hot gas by now, and instead here you are holding on to my top research scientist. I'll tell you something that strictly need to know. Those researchers you just rescued may have vital data on the source of the ongoing drifter invasion, a drifter hive. One of these hives, inside Minmatar Republic space, constitutes an existential threat. As such, it's now of the highest urgency to get you and your vessel home safely.
All right. Unfortunately, let's go.
The drifters will want to carve your ship open, grab anyone still alive, and take them to their hive. We don't know what happens in them, but if you end up in one, you can forget about seeing your tribe again. You should get moving, but there's a problem. You probably didn't realize the drifters have deployed some kind of warp bubble around your location.
Oh, I realized.
Fortunately, they're not magicians, and the field generator is close by. Locate it, destroy it, and get the hell out of there.
So then R is going to tell me how to do it. It's cool. It's well done.
Captain, in your ship's overview, you can see what your ship's scanners are picking up around you. To lock your weapon system on the generator, hold down your left mouse button on the generator.
Orbit.
The optimal flight path is to orbit.
Nice.
Excellent. You are in the optimal position. I suggest you fire your primary weapon.
Fire! Oh, sweet. Explosion. Updated explosions are so good. You should now stop your ship. Gotcha. So the field's gonna go away? Still there.
I can see that the drifters deployed a second warp bubble.
Oh.
They must be very eager to add you to their trophy cabinet.
Oh shit, there's somebody here.
Looks like you have to... Oh wait. Okay. You'll have to
pull... Oh shit. Ah!
You're about to get a chance.
Orbit! Oh. You're about to get... Oh, I cut her off. I'm an asshole. Weapons, Drifter. Fire! Fire! There's no fucking way. Like, this gives people a completely bad idea of how hard it is to kill a Circadian Seeker. Like, a rookie ship could not do this. What?
Don't forget to stop your ship.
It's just not possible.
For a rookie, you're quite a surprise. Your first kill. This is the kind of combat experience the Republic needs you to have if you want to keep the tribe safe. All right, onto the backup warp disrupt. Oh, what? Wait. The drifters are very serious about getting hold of you, recruit. Another seeker just warped in.
Let's take him out.
It's time to engage. Fire your weapons. When you have defeated the seeker, you should stop your ship.
Fire! Fire! Ooh. Missing completely. There we go. Break his shields. Somehow rip into his ship like that. I don't understand this at all. How did I break into his ship? Destroy him with my autocannon. My one autocannon.
You can explore the Seeker wrecks to see if they left anything behind.
Ooh.
Move your mouse over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button.
Metal scrapes.
Select open cargo to view the contents, and then click the loot all button.
You got it, Mama.
Remember to get close.
I'm thinking you might make a good warrior yet, recruit, so I'll clue you in on some strategic intel. Our long-range sensors have tracked a squadron of drifter battleships, and they're heading for your location. I don't care how good you are with that autocannon. You can't take on drifter battleships in a corvette. They'll crush you. You need to destroy that secondary warp disruption generator right now.
Where is it? Oh, there it is.
You won't get interrupted by any more of those damn seekers.
You got it, Toots. We're going.
To reach the generator faster, you should activate the highlighted afterburner module. This module enables you to trade your ship's capacitor power for speed, allowing you to reach the generator faster. When you are close to the generator, you should lock target.
This is pretty cool. There we go. What's my range on this? 5k.
After locking target on the generator.
Oops. I cut her off. I keep doing it.
Activate your primary weapon to destroy the generator.
We're going to get in range first though. We're going to get in range because these guns cannot hit that far. Oh, shit. I didn't mean to do that. Far! Far! I always kind of take out turret sounds because I found it unrealistic.
Okay, listen carefully, recruit. You've almost run out of time. The Drifter Battleship Squadron has warped in very close to your location. By destroying the warp disruption generator, you've removed the bubble that prevented you leaving the site.
Nice!
The Tribes will gain nothing from you trying to take them on solo. Republic's security services need those survivors for debriefing. And I'd like to congratulate you on this rescue in person one day. So your orders are to report to headquarters now.
Where's headquarters? Tell me what to do, Aura!
Captain, your ship is fitted with a warp drive, which is capable of bending space and time in order to efficiently displace you toward your destination. I have overridden the ship's clearance system to give you full access to the drive. Find your HQ highlighted in the overview. Hold down your left mouse button and select dock on the radio menu.
Nice.
You do not want to face these giant drifter ships by yourself.
Bye! It's cool. Oh, I wish they did something else with this. Like, when ships warp in and you're in low sec or null sec, that this pops up. Boop. Oh, ship warped in. Or, like, just different things. Like, they could use this outside of the tutorial.
Docking permission requested.
At least I think so.
Accepted.
50,000 ISK rewarded? Say what?
Academy. Plenty of legendary Capsuleers have started here and gone on to strike fear into the enemies of the Republic. Recruit, it turns out the Sisters of Eve research team had pinned down the exact location of the Drifter Hive. We are urging Professor Tannen to elaborate on this information, but your actions have also drawn the attention of Republic Fleet Command. Due to your efforts, the Tribal Council has spoken, and the Republic fleet is starting to mobilize a force for a major counterattack. You've exceeded my expectations, Recruit. Well done. As a token of gratitude, the Minmatar Republic has awarded you a cash bonus. Of course, money isn't everything, and I have to say your kudos has risen high. I've also put in a word with Command. And I've been given direct authority.
Kudos. You kudos! Well.
Captain, bonus payments and accelerated training are quite unusual for a recruit of your status. It is an honor to be serving with you. I must warn you, though, Capsuleer training is the hardest, most complicated training process known to man. Only a fraction of pilots endure it. An accelerated process is going to be very challenging. However, so far, you have been performing well. The funds you received are awarded in...
I don't know if I buy that.
This is the main currency of New Eden and can be used for everything from buying supplies to bribing other Capsuleers.
So... Okay.
I've highlighted your wallet. You can view your ISK balance there.
Well, look at me go. Checked your wallet. That's cool. So they break it all up into...
We've lost
little sections.
One of the Republic's most important research outposts in the region. This research outpost is a hidden site where the Sisters of Eve have been working with us. It's the Sisters who requested you personally for this mission. I'm going to raise your security clearance for the duration of this mission, But you need to get ready. Aura will provide guidance on the preparations you should make.
Okay.
Captain, I am running different preparation scenarios. Research outposts like these often contain highly sensitive data troves that are securely encrypted. I believe it would be wise to upgrade your ship's capability with a data analyzer module. However, it seems like the Empire's stock of analyzers in this region are fully depleted due to ongoing drifter attacks. After analysis, it is my conclusion you should build one.
Build a data analyzer for the mission, eh? Okay, that sounds like a plan, but you'll need the necessary materials to build it. The fastest way to get materials would be to mount a quick raid on a local pirate den. These are the kind of scum who stop at nothing to make a profit, even slavery. Why don't you show me?
And the Minmatar do not like slavery. For sure.
By all means, seize as much as you can and take out any who get in your way. Remember, justice is our aim, and the tribes reward the just.
So it's a pretty extensive tutorial.
Captain, it well done. There's no surprise that a pirate colony can be a dangerous place to enter alone. Might I suggest an upgrade to your vessel?
Ooh.
You've been issued a repair module you can fit on your ship. Additionally, you can improve the effect of your existing afterburner module by training a skill. An acceleration control skill book has also been issued to you for this purpose. Skill training is vital for your progression in New Eden, and the skills you choose will prepare you for your path in the stars. You can view your current skills by opening the highlighted character sheet.
Oh, yes? Well, let's do that then. New character sheet.
Retrieve the new module and skill book from your redeemable.
Ugly ass motherfucker.
By clicking on the highlighted Neocom menu, hovering to inventory, and clicking redeem items.
What?
Once there, you can click on the items and select redeem selected items.
Okay. So it's a two-in-one little tutorial. They show you how to redeem items, and they just give you.
Yeah. This is where all of your modules and items will be stored. The ship hangar will display all of your ships at the current location. To train a new skill, simply drag its skill book from your item hangar into your training queue. You can queue up additional training or train skills you've learned.
Cool. I honestly didn't even know you could do that.
You should upgrade your ship.
And I did not know that was a feature.
To do this, right-click on the module and select Fit to Active Ship.
Nice.
To see what you have fitted on your ship currently, you should click on the ship fitting icon now highlighted. Captain, your Corvette.
Ooh, I don't like that. So they pointed you to this as your fitting window, but you can access it even in space.
Weapon system for dealing damage.
Just saying.
I now calculate your combat odds against a moderate-sized pirate gang to be at an acceptable level. As the pirates are outlaws in New Eden, there are bounties on their heads. Captain, proceed to neutralize those pirates and earn those bounties.
You got it.
I have highlighted the undock option for you. You should
Let's go.
Press this when you wish to leave the station.
Well, I'm ready.
And travel the stars.
Yes. Let us go forth.
I have calculated the location of the nearest pirate outpost. You should now click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Warp drive active.
What? Just a single click? Wow. So my activities in Eve have been far away from PvE or anything remotely industrial. It's been focused on fighting. But this is relaxing. This is actually really nice. I don't know if I buy the story though. If like every capsuleer that starts as a Minmatar has to go through that story, seems strange to me. Well.
However, I did not anticipate the presence of corrosive gases in this area. If you get caught in a gas cloud, your ship will start taking damage. In that case, You should use your afterburner and burn through the clouds to get out as fast as possible. Also remember that you can use your repair module should you take damage to your ship.
Roger. You likely will. Let's go. Let's take care of this fool.
Remember to activate your repair module when you take damage, and switch it off again when you have repaired successfully.
This is cool. Having Aura speak to you is very nice. Very nice change. Alright, so we'll just orbit this guy. Where are we? Ocean getting shot. I'm getting shot by something. Hey, what's up, lurkers? How you doing? How you doing? Welcome. Getting fucked up. I'll just turn it on so Aura can chill.
Captain, there are a lot more pirates than I predicted, but I know you can do this. Remember your training.
Approach, yes, ma'am.
Look. Orbit. Shoot.
Oh, I love it. Approach. Look. Orbit. Shoot. That's cool. Let's set people up. Set people up pretty nicely. She gives you a set of commands. Approach. What is my lock range? I'm getting fucked up already. Lock. Orbit. Shoot. I'm way too far away from him to shoot now, though. My range is like 5 kilometers. Almost 6. So once we get in that fall off range, we will fire! Fire! Slow down. So my transversal is going to be much higher going this fast. Yeah, blap them. Goodbye! There's more! Sorry, guys, I don't know why I'm yelling. I'm excited. This is cool. It's my first time doing the tutorials, and they're pretty good. Belter Hoodlum, Narco Pusher. Oh my god. Once we get in range, we will do as Aura says. We will approach, and then we will lock. I don't know what my lock range is. Probably like 25. Less? 20? No, like 23. We will orbit. I just made some money. Ah! Repair! And get in range! Ah! Slow down. Let's fuck bitches up. Ash! Fire! So, it's definitely easier for people to get into this game now. Oh, there's more. Really? They just want you to start killing everything. I wish my lock range was a little bit better. Oops. What did I want to press? Tactical. My lock range, yeah, it's like 23 or some shit like that. Chill orbit. I don't have any of my like normal hotkeys, so it is kind of a new experience right now. It's like I'm playing a new game. No skills in queue. Oh, I have skills now. Oh, fire! It's like seeing the explosions. Yeah. All right, who's the fucking bitch shooting me? Turn around. Engage our new foe. See, I like the tactical camera. I do. Oh, rocks! Ah! Nice. Where's the other bastard?
Highlighted the container you need to approach. You should loot its contents and then return to station.
Resource crate. Here I come. Just got picked up a bunch of shit. Whoa.
Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to dock at your HQ. Active.
This single clicking is pretty awesome. But I guess it's just prevalent to missions and tutorials, I guess. Yes. I don't know, man. I don't know what it's like to be a new player in this game. This is kind of opening up my eyes. They see enough to get by. I don't know. How can we get people to really appreciate? I don't know. We'll see. Let's finish the tutorial, I guess.
The way you tore through that pirate scum was a pleasure. Not only did you wipe away a blight on the region, you've confiscated a trove of materials. Now's the time to try your hand at industry and make something useful from the materials you recovered.
Captain, industry jobs are the Capsuleer's way of manufacturing goods for himself. They can be a path to great wealth if you hone your industry skills. You should now have the materials to start production of the data analyzer unit for your upcoming reconnaissance mission to the research facility. I have calculated this to be important. To build this module, you'll first need a data analyzer blueprint, which you can buy from the market with your ISK.
So, go to the market. And we look for.
Once you have located the item,
first dibs.
To view the active cell.
What is that? Yeah, it works.
In this station.
Good morning.
Then right-click.
Why is it playing?
Good morning and well.
There we go. Sorry. The dashboard just started playing. Anyways, what? I'm sorry. Wasn't listening to you, mama. Once you have located the item. So does it tell you how to... Do I really just have to search for it? Data analyzer. Is there one in the station? It's mine.
You should now right click on your ship in the station and select open cargo hold. You can use the right click, select all, to highlight all the items in your cargo hold, and then click and drag them to the inventory tab marked item hanger.
Smart. Oh, Aura.
Locate the civilian data analyzer blueprint. You can right click on the blueprint and select Use Blueprint.
Nice. Sorry.
To the left, you can see the materials that will be used from your item hanger. And on the right, you can see the output, which will be your brand new civilian data analyzer module. You should now select Start. This will start this cool. the manufacturing process. You looted enough material.
Ah, I hate cutting her off! Damn it!
Your preparation has been unusually intensive, but you're going to thank me for maintaining this pressure once you dive into the next task. You're about to go into a deep and dark zone where something has gone terribly wrong.
The deep dark.
The Sensitive research facility is totally cut off, and I need you out there to find out what happened to them. Professor Tannen wishes to speak to you, and I've authorized that. I'll establish her connection to you now.
Captain, I requested you Hi. And only you for this emergency mission to our research outpost. I had to use all my influence with Republic Fleet Command to secure your continuing involvement. After I made it clear the sisters would suspend our assistance, they granted me this request. The truth is, Captain, that this outpost is vitally important. Even more important than Fleet Commander Vidari realizes herself. The sad reality is that there are so few people we sisters can trust these days. Some in the Republic remain suspicious of our humanitarian work with slaves in the Amar Empire. It's a tragic irony. However, you saved my life and have been very discreet. I feel that I can trust you with this mission.
Damn! Captain, she trusts me quick.
You are making some intriguing and influential friends. Your next journey will be a little longer than any you have undertaken in the past. The research outpost is one jump from our present position.
Oh, cool.
That means that to get there, you will need to jump through a stargate. Along the way, many humans enjoy reflecting on the beauty of the cosmos and report feelings of tranquility and wonder, especially in advance of potentially life-threatening situations, such as our current mission. No recruit in your position has been allowed to travel this far or use the stargates.
Oh shit, it just finished.
If you become a Capsuleer, you can travel to the deepest sections of low-sec space, hunt for wormholes, or travel with friendly fleets through stargates. Captain, your
this is so cool! Like, I love the way she interacts with you! Like,
you should open the highlighted industry window, select the Jobs tab, and click Deliver. The module will now be in your inventory under Item Hanger.
What? Oh, it was already open. I never closed it. I want to be a new player again! Oh, man! I'm a fucking bitter vet now. No, I'm not bitter at all. But I don't know. Alright, so... Wait, where did it go? There it is. What is she... Yeah? Right click, fit to active ship. Bam!
Fully fitted for the research outpost.
Let's go.
It's time to undock.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to set your destination to the neighboring system.
Click on the location marker in the info panel. Oh! See, that's not cool. One click.
Select the highlighted autopilot button.
No way.
This will start your ship moving to the destination. Autopilot engaged.
Huh.
Once your ship comes to a stop in the next system, click on the location marker icon in the interstargate. Warp drive will take you to the research outpost.
I hope she explains what autopilot is. That's an important thing for people to know. Let's see. Let's see what she's got to say. I know. See, this, I don't, this is, I think, is confusing for new players, because, like, it doesn't tell you what the autopilot fucking is. Ah, see, that is a flaw. Because if you're using autopilot anywhere else besides HiSec, it's very unfortunate for you. I'm going to write that down. So there's different... I wanted to do the tutorial to get an idea of how it worked. And... click on the location marker. So it's just... Yeah, see, I don't like this, because this doesn't actually exist in the real world. This exists in the tutorial. Maybe PvE now has one click stop kind of thing. But in the real game, autopilot is horrible unless you are, like, fully aware of what you're doing, where you're going, where you're autopiloting to or through. Oh no, I don't like it.
This journey is not far to travel by our standards, but remember your good fortune, recruit. The Min Matar Republic covers several regions and contains many star systems, but most of our people don't even get off the planet they were born on. Even better, you're on the way to becoming an independent Capsulea, with the right to own and pilot your own ships. That status comes hard and carries high honor, recruit. Help the tribes prevail today, and you may just earn it. Okay, recruit. You're on the verge of some dark depths now. Very few pilots have ever been allowed to enter this place, let alone trainee Capsuleers. These strategic sites are almost always placed in locations that discourage idle visitors, even if they're among the more unique locations in New Eden. And this one, well, this one is off the grid and totally silent. I can't tell you what you might find in there. Keep a lookout at all times.
Captain, you should now approach the gate. When you are close enough, hold down your left mouse button on the gate and select Activate from the radial menu.
You got it. Oh. See, it's pushing you to use the radial menu, which is cool. But they should talk about the selected item menu as well. I guess that's pretty easy to understand. I don't know, I'm trying to envision this experience as somebody who has never touched this game ever. Ever! And it already told us that autopilot is the way to travel through stargates, which is fucking wrong! But, I don't know. Meow. That is a Stratios or a Nestor? It's a Nestor.
Seven tribes. It looks like another fleet was blown to pieces in here. Drifters, without question, but how? And when? We've heard nothing about a fleet engaged in combat at this site. There should be a Sisters of Eve outpost in here, but this mess worries me. You'll have to dive into the depths of the site, get to the research outpost, and see what answers it holds. Navigate over to it at once, but stay alert. Hostile action is a real possibility.
I don't know where it is!
This site is quite unusual, and it is enormous. In order for you to save time, you might want to activate your afterburner to travel faster through it.
You got it.
However, stay alert, because this is uncharted territory. The Sisters of Eve have been doing some unusual research here, which does not show up in records accessible to me.
Yo, I can't even really see.
What the drifters were doing here. Be very careful, Captain.
This place is, like, bugging out.
You should locate the info shard on your overview and approach it.
Info shard. Security service assembly plant. Okay. This is cool. I wasn't expecting another turn. I thought that was it. Wait. Oh, show info. What does she want me to do? Info shard. I'm so confused right now. Oh, this thing. Okay, I was approaching the wrong thing.
Info shard. We need you to be within close proximity. Remember to stop your ship when you reach the shard.
You got it, mama. I'm scared. I'm scared! I don't want to die! Not like this. What? That is a Titan. That's a Ragnarok, isn't it? I'm pretty sure it is. They destroyed a Ragnarok here. Oh no. This info shard is so far away. What the fuck is that? Sleeper. Thermoelectric converter. Hello, Sashimi! And Sativa. I didn't say hello to you earlier, but I responded to you. Avatar? What does that mean? Is that a question? Is it a statement? We don't know. Approaching the info shard.
Recruit.
Yes.
I'm getting indications of some unusual signatures from your sensor feed. I worry the drifters are putting out an interference field. What's your back, recruit? You're my eyes, and I can't afford to be blind right now.
I will try my best.
I am afraid the drifters may have hacked our outpost. That could give them access to ship
FTL. My eye just started twitching!
Theoretically,
oh, Avatar. Gotcha. Boom. Not a Ragnarok. Ragnarok is Minmatar.
Looks like our outpost is relatively intact. You are going to have to try to hack into its mainframe to extract some information on what happened here. Be careful.
Captain. If the outpost is still
I feel like I'm still wrong.
It's a good thing you prepared by bringing a data analyzer.
I did.
Hacking is a delicate process, but mastering it can give you access to a lot of wealth in some of the deep and hidden pockets of New Eden. Let me walk you through the process.
She's got a sexy little voice there. We're gonna lock. Oh my god.
Lock target on the info shard.
Done. Activate.
Now activate this.
Thank you, dear. Avatar is Amar.
Attempting to hack into the info shard. You should select
Ragnarok is Minmatar. Yep. Until you locate the system. I was right the second time.
After you click a node, the numbers that appear will indicate your proximity to the core.
Oh, what?
Defensive software on your route. You should click on it until you deactivate the firewall.
Oh my god, I didn't know that that was a thing. The numbers? Oh my god. I've been hacking for years. I never noticed that. Holy shit, I've learned two things doing the tutorial today. I forgot what the other thing was. Shit. It had something to do... I think it had something to do with the single clicking... of the info panel. That was pretty good. What? Oh! Unknown sequence. Whoa.
Elder's teeth! What the?
Oh, the fuck is that?
The site just lit up like... Well, Professor Tannen, how about it? Have you seen anything like this before? Is this part of your research?
No, Fleet Commander.
What is happening right now?
Like this before. I suggest the captain get out of there as fast as possible.
Way ahead of you, Professor. Recruit, our deep space scanners just picked up a very large drifter fleet on a direct heading for your position.
Don't hit on my e-cig.
But you best make like you have a pack of slaver hounds on your heels. Actually, don't even stop to think about that. Do what the professor says and just get out of there.
All right. How do I get out? I get out. I don't know what system I came from. Oh. See?
To travel to a safe spot.
They make you nervous.
Warp drive
Warp to location? Where the fuck did I just warp to? Travel to a safe spot. But the game just created a safe spot. It doesn't teach you how to make a bookmark. Oh no. You can't just warp off into nothing. This should have been over here. It should have showed you the overview. Like here, click warp 2. That's fucking crazy.
Recruit, I don't know how you're doing this again and again, but you've really got something now. This data store you've recovered is a gold mine.
Yeah, but how?
Information just extracted. Looks like it includes the codes to activate the jump gate to the Drifter Hive. Get them to our fleet, and then we can unlock the gate for them. Everyone in the fleet is going to know your name after this.
Captain, congratulations on finding the Drifter gate codes. That is amazing work. The Drifters must have been trying to link our outpost to their network through that gate. There's something else that worries me. I navigated through some of the data when you brought me the mainframe online.
See, that's... Hold on. Sorry.
I suspect the Drifters may have hijacked one of the capital ships carrying our prototype systems. In their hands, it poses a great threat. Luckily, the ship may be vulnerable to stasis webbing. It could slow it down to a halt. Captain, I'm gonna upload to Aura instructions on how to fit your ship with a stasis webifier the next time you're in station. That will improve your capabilities out there.
Recruit, you seem to be in constant...
It's like Cheers in space.
I hope she's providing intel on the Drifters. No time for instructions right now.
That is so silly.
Believe.
Everyone will know your name. Should play that shit.
You're gonna like this.
Captain, the commander has uploaded the location of the forward operating base.
This should prove interesting. All right.
Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to travel to the forward operating base.
Thank you, Aura. So, this is pretty nice tutorial. But I'm not sure why they decided to put like parts of the game that you're not going to use. Like this menu here, this info panel. I don't know. They created a bookmark in space for me. Like they sent me to a safe spot that I didn't even create for myself. So that totally ignore, like, right away, you don't even know what a safe spot is. You think it's this magic place that you can somehow warp to when you're in trouble. Like, that's... I don't know. I don't like that. But I cannot stop picturing Cheers now.
Warp drive active.
That was my spiel. And doing it again, just warping off into space to some location that... Oh, I guess that does happen with missions, right? There's usually a marker. I don't know. Ignore me. Ignore me, please. It's been a long time since I've been a new player.
Approach the gate. When you are close, use the radial menu to activate the gate to enter the forward operating base.
What?
Warp drive active.
Oh, use the radial menu. I love Sativa, man. Indica is what does I currently appreciate, but Sativa is my preferred. My preferred one. Yes.
Behold! An avenging sword of the Minmatar Republic. Our fleet. The force that will strike at the Drifters. Dreadnoughts. Battleships.
Oh, that's what this
cruisers
is.
Cruisers and frigates are all being prepared for action. At our Astrahoo Citadel forward operating base. All soon to be loaded. With the key codes you recovered, the entire force will be able to jump right inside their outer defenses.
All thrashers.
I don't usually do this, but it's going to take a few minutes to upload the jump gate keys from your mainframe. I suggest you fly down and introduce
Stabbers. Bellicosus.
You're like a lucky totem, and I wouldn't mind your luck rubbing off on us all. Take a moment
Ruptures
to enjoy
and
the
sights.
Of all these ships while you can. If you make naval capsulia, you could be in command of one of these beauties someday.
Oh shit.
I promise you, they're
battleships.
Even more inspiring when you're in control. Aura, help our favorite recruit get a handle on the might assembled before us.
Is this him? Is this the pilot that saved the research crew and found the gate codes?
Aye.
Captain, the assembled
yes.
strike force includes several ship classes you'll often encounter in New Eden.
Nice.
Damn, recruits. It took me 6 months before I posted my first confirmed kill.
It's because you suck.
You can take a closer look at any of the ships.
I'm just kidding. It took me like a year to get my first kill. Look at. First year, I don't think I ever. I killed anyone. And select look at Your alt is Indica.
Hey, recruits. Our crew has been talking about you nonstop today.
Oh! That's awesome.
Stick around while we upload the key codes from their ship.
That's cool. Sativa, you just made me.
The Minmatar take care of
me. Am I
right, Fleet?
They're fucking yelling at me right now, and I'm trying to enjoy myself.
Captain, the upload is going to take a while. In the meantime, take a look at our Astrahos forward operating base.
Okay.
It's a citadel type structure. Citadels are the biggest structures in New Eden that capsulars can build. These massive cities are quite the sight to look at. Since you have to kill some time while the key codes are uploading to the fleet, you have a perfect opportunity to practice some of your maneuvering skills. You can try.
That's kind of cool. They are real serious. Like, this is game time. Game time! It's like a half an hour fucking tutorial. You can't stop. Piloting experience.
Okay, recruit. The upload is complete, and the fleet is almost ready for the battle. While we're prepping the remaining squadrons,
there's a lot coming at me right now.
Pick up that special item I was talking about a moment ago. Sounds good, doesn't it? Trust me, it's better than you think.
I feel like they're all hitting on me. Even Aura, talking to me all sexy.
Next to the Dreadnought class vessel.
Approach the forward point. Citadel does look pretty sick, though. It's fucking massive. I don't know why I didn't turn on my afterburner. Go faster! I don't have any of my keybinds, so I'm like trying to click press stuff and it's not working. Brand new character. Alpha fucking character. Just want to see what the possibilities are as an alpha. Not for like anything, Cyrus. I need to play Nicola. When you're ready to the front. Where's the dreadnought? Oh, okay. Naglfar.
To return to HQ, click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Now turn your autopilot on.
What? Why did they have you do this?
Autopilot engaged.
Oh my god!
When you reach your destination and the autopilot switches off, click on the location marker icon in the info panel to dock to HQ. Active.
Why did they have you use autopilot? Why? That is so silly. Oh no. The game is so much more enjoyable now. It's like a new game. Oh man, that's so funny. Sorry, I'm reading chat that's behind my behind my body.
Approaching Stargate.
Why does this happen? Why is this the way to travel by using autopilot. That's so dumb. I hope they address it again by the end of this tutorial. I really hope so. I hope so.
Autopilot jumping.
Gotta look at this with fresh eyes. Fresh eyes.
Warp drive active.
How do I stop this from happening? I'm pretty sure there's a...
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Recruit, I have very high standards for my trainees, and you have repeatedly exceeded them. As a result, I've decided to greenlight you for participation in the
Oh, I get a rifter.
Vengeful Blade. Consider this your final test before reaching naval capsulea status. Now, I hope you don't think I'm going to let you go to battle in that little Reaper-class corvette you've been flying around all day. No, recruit. The Minmatar Republic always takes care of its warriors, especially those who've done
so
much
sick,
to defend the tribes.
I've never seen this color.
I'm awarding you with a new ship to participate in my assault operation. I think you're going to really like the added striking power it brings. I'm also awarding you with some upgraded modules to fit to it. Now, the only thing left is to acquire
the surrounding.
To pilot your new and improved warship. I don't have time to wait around, so let's speed things along with a skill injector. Normally these things would set you back a small fortune, but this one's on me. Aura will guide you through using the injector. Fit wisely, recruit. We are heading up against an unpredictable foe.
Captain, you have been awarded with a new frigate. This ship is a considerable upgrade from your corvette. Your new frigate gives you far more flexibility in how the vessel is outfitted. For your upcoming combat, I suggest using the afterburner and repair module you have already mastered. Additionally, you have been rewarded with some upgraded modules for your ship, including a few additional weapons. They must be very impressed with you since they have also awarded you a mini skin injector. These are usually only reserved for fully qualified capsuleers, but it is my assessment that you can handle a mini injector without major risk to your limbic system. Probably. Skin injectors are devices capable of transneural scanning, and can lay synaptic patterns down in new combinations with skillbook data. What this means is that if you like learning fast, these are for you. Now, let's go through how we can optimally set up your ship for the combat ahead. Professor Tannen has advised that you fit your ship with a stasis webifier, and you should not take that suggestion lightly, Captain. You should collect all your rewards by checking your redeemable items under the Neocom menu and Inventory tab. You can move those to your item hanger by selecting them and clicking Redeem Selected Items. Open your inventory and select Item Hanger. Captain, double-click on your new mini skill injector and confirm the injection. This will give you unallocated skill points that you can use to progress your training.
Nice. What am I training right now?
Open your character sheet to use
acceleration
your
control.
Unallocated skill points. I suggest you search for Frigate and drag your Empire's Frigate skill into the training queue. When you've done that, find the Apply Skill Points button and click it. Your frigate skill will have advanced a level. These skills will help you become better prepared for the upcoming battle.
Wait, what? Oh, search for frigate. Let's see what happens when I do that. Okay. See.
Skill training complete, Captain. It's time to use your new ship. In your inventory, select your ship hangar. There you will see you are currently in your Corvette. Right-click your active ship and click leave ship.
Cool. Spread it down a little bit. I can't believe I'm training on... Oh, yeah. It's like a trial account, same shit. Oh, leave ship, so she wants me to leave the ship. I'm so bugged out by this reset of my capsular self. Craziness.
You will finalize the last preparations and calibrate your vessel so you can pilot it.
Rob, I just hit my 100 million skill point benchmark, and I wanted to just see what the fuck the tutorial was like, see what it's like for a new player to play this game. Oh, losing my mind! The tutorial fucking has you autopilot, man. Like, why? They don't even show you how to warp at zero or how to just jump to zero. Nah. Strange. Took notes on it. It is what it is. You should now right click your new frigate and select assemble ship.
Right click your new ship and select make active. You have now boarded your new ship.
Rifter.
Right click your old Corvette and select repackage. This will remove the modules fitted to that ship.
Oh, that's cool.
And make it easier to transport.
Some stuff is really good.
It's now time to
And some stuff is not good.
With modules. Open your inventory and go to item hangar. You will want to fit weapons, an afterburner, a stasis webifier, and your repair module. To fit, right-click on each of the modules and select Fit to Active Ship.
Ah.
Then open your fitting window and ensure you have everything you need fitted to your ship.
Okay,
now that you have prepared your ship for the fight, Captain, it is time to head into space and start the journey to the Drifter Hive Stargate.
So, they earlier showed... Oh, it's here. So every station has a fitting button over here? If that's the case, then I'm not even going to say anything, because I'm not making sense. Let's put some guns! All of the things! Fit to active ship. Okay. So let's just say... See, if I was a newbie, I'd be like, why can't I fit this miner?
At the gate, recruit. You understand what's at stake.
I wouldn't understand.
The hive must be destroyed to remove this threat. When the drifters push back, the seven tribes of the Minmatar Republic can secure our homes and trade.
Senor Viper!
Continue to rebuild the economy and reestablish our defensive cordon against the Amar Empire.
These guys are very serious, Vipe, right now. There is a fucking war going on.
To find out why they have been attacking us and removing the survivors. We've lost too many brothers and sisters to this invasion.
You're right. I am here to help.
You should now undock and click on the location marker icon in the info.
500 blocks of ice to Citadel to compress. You can't compress in the station. I'm hoping it's the same system, right? Or same, I hope it's the same system. Just jump to Station Citadel, Station Citadel. Because that would suck. Hey! Rob FM81! Thank you for following, man. Welcome. Welcome. Hopefully this will be a fun stream for you. So we're undocking. We're getting out of here. 10 AU apart. Alright, that's not bad. It's a lot of trips, but... it is what it is. It's 20 trips. Just chill. Just do. It's work. Alright, now what? Location marker. Boom. So I'm trying to follow this tutorial exactly like a newbie would fucking do it. And so far I got a little lost. Wait, when you reach your destination, click on the next location marker in the info panel to travel to the site. So I set the destination. What's up, ISD Maxtrex? I've done one stream myself, need a cam, use my phone, nearly baked it, battery didn't like it. Streaming is fun. Streaming is a lot of fun. Find a lot of cool people like fucking JM Viper who talked up near above somewhere in the chat. Calling this nonsense. Thanks, Viper. Thank you, Viper. Viper's a great streamer, man. If you guys throw a follow, he would greatly appreciate it. He loves people. Social motherfucker. Social butterfly. Playing cool games. You were playing Rainbow Six, the other one, not Siege, the Division. I don't think I can get into that game. Just shooting someone repeatedly. Gotcha! I don't know. I'm going to be playing some Siege, maybe after I get a little bored of this tutorial. So right now, as a new player, confused as fuck. It's like, what do I have to do? Oh, that's right, I pressed autopilot. Maybe I would remember to do that. But right now, there's no... it's like, usually you just click. Nobody tells you that you can drag. Anyways. Autopilot is working. And... I don't know. You still don't learn that you can warp to zero on a Stargate. Brand new player. You're like, holy shit, I'm flying a fucking X-Wing. This is amazing. And then all of a sudden it takes you... alright, we got to the Stargate. Approaching Stargate. Yeah. I feel like only people that are kind of like curious personalities are going to be like, oh, okay, well, it seems like I'm just approaching like normal. Yeah, dude. It is an X-Wing. No, it's not, but this is the Rifter. This is the Rifter. Iconic EVE Online ship. Oh, yeah? Yeah, So, I haven't finished the tutorial yet, ISD Maxtrix. I'm just getting through it, and I'm hoping that at some point it tells you that you can warp to zero. Because if that's not the case, this is very confusing, and I can see my first death being like, what the fuck? What the fuck? I'm trying to warp. I'm trying to jump Stargate. Like, I don't know. But of course, the best thing to do is just join a corp, which should be the number one thing. Hopefully at the end of this tutorial is like, join a fucking corp. Go talk to a real person. Aura can only do so much. Dude, let's play, Vipe. Fucking love Siege.
Approaching Stargate.
I love that game. Yep, so we're approaching Stargates again. 15 kilometers. It's not good. But, Maxtrix, definitely... love this tutorial. I think this is cool. I don't know if I buy the whole, oh, all of a sudden you're a capsuleer. Like, what? What? There's got to be some... there's a little emphasis on how hard it is. But I don't quite understand. At least the Minmatar side of things. Travel to the... oh, it's going to continue autopiloting. Oh my god, this is not good! Alright, so for the sake... alright, I'll just take this last autopilot. don't know, I gotta say. Have you seen the Uplay GIF? No? Can you share? That would be nice. That would be nice! Autopiloting again. Oh. So we're gonna cut this autopilot nonsense out because we know I'm a veteran player. You don't need to do that. But for anybody who's new to this game, autopilot, for some reason, they don't teach you that it is not really meant for active travel. It's meant for AFK shit. And if you go AFK, well, you can die in this game. Oh my god! That was something else that I noticed. That, like, at the beginning of this, I'm shooting the Circadian Seekers with my one rookie civilized fucking autocannon, and somehow the bitch was dying. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh. That's funny. Nah, man. This game tutorial is really good. Like, this is a step in the fucking right direction, I believe. But I don't know. So right now, warp to location. This whole menu here, I don't know if Max Strix is still paying attention. Is the fucking info panel? I don't do PvE normally. Is this the way it works in missions and stuff? Like, you can single click a warp to? Because I haven't done a mission and I don't fucking know. What? They had to change the name. The spatial I don't understand. That leads to the Drifter Hive. Our fleet just jumped in minutes ago, so expect some friendly company. You're going to need it. I love that I'm in a Rifter right now.
When you're ready, you should approach the spatial rift and activate the gate using the radial menu.
It's crazy. I don't know. Decisions are made, man. Decisions are made. I don't know why some decisions are made. Certainly. Certainly. I get it. That kind of shit, it don't bother me. That's cool. That's like stuff that is functionally fucked up. Like, did the people that designed the tutorial ever play the game? Like, really play the game? Like, what? I don't think so. For some reason, I don't think so. Some of it, yeah, some of it's cool. Some of it's very, very intuitive. Wow, that's pretty cool. Whoa. We've happened upon a fucking battlefield.
Welcome to the show, recruit. Attention, fleet. This is Fleet Commander Vidari, by order of the Tribal Council.
Oh!
I'm assuming tactical command of this strike force.
Things are happening to me! Wow, I just tried to turn on my my damage control.
Here's the situation.
Thinking I'm...
The Drifter fleet is counterattacking.
I'm pre-patched.
If you miss the massive, spiked, round-looking thing, let me be the first to introduce you to the Hive.
Oh.
That thing is pouring out Drifter Seekers.
Whoa. Whoa, where the fuck am I? Whoa.
I don't think we can stop it until we break through those perimeter defenses. Recruit, what are you waiting for?
Fire! All right, so check this out. Circadian Seekers getting completely wrecked by three autocannons. Oh, man.
We will take out their fleet to clear a path to the Hive.
You still do that too?
You will be the bending blade that cleaves their ranks asunder.
Fucking clicking modules that aren't the same anymore. They're not that way.
Battleships and be ready to provide webbing support. Frigates,
put a web on them.
I need your dogfighting skills.
You got it, mama.
You guys have to keep any seekers or drones off the backs of the cruisers and battleships. Every shot counts, and I need all my ships in the fight for as long
as possible.
My god,
how do I take that off?
Follow the lead of your commanders and maintain fire discipline.
That's bad. Putting the radio menu on the left click, I think, is a bad idea in tutorial. For people that don't know this game, they're going to start to be like, what the fuck? Why is this shit opening up? Because this giant ring is here.
As parts? I thought I'd seen everything, but this is abominable. Not even an Amar slave bit comes close to this.
Fleet Commander, we are intercepting transmissions from the Hive to the fleet.
I wish I wasn't inactive, like, testing during this shit. Like, CC stuff, I should have. I regret.
We lost communications with the RFS Fate Weaver. I should have seen this coming.
I'd have been very noisy about some of these issues.
Fleet Commander, are you seeing this? Isn't this the RFS Fate Weaver that just entered the site? Isn't that the ship that went missing a few days ago?
What?
It looks pretty different, but that's definitely the Fate Weaver. I served in the same wing as that ship.
Fleet Commander, the RFS Fate Weaver...
I guess it's not closed. I don't know if it's closed down. But I'm definitely switching gears, and that's... I don't know how to do it in a better way than I did it. Like, it's gonna have to start fresh and refine some of the people that I had found previously. I've let some peeps know. I don't know.
New and tremendously effective support ship, and it's heading towards the Drifter fleet. If it joins up with them, their formations will be hugely reinforced, and we might not be able to punch through. I am seeing a stasis webifier fitted to your ship. That was good forward planning.
She scanned me?
Exactly what you need for this task. Halt that ship, recruit. It is of paramount importance.
Let's do it. Aura's gonna pop up and be like, hey. Oh, Rob. Thundercats. Thundercats! We're going. Lock X-Foils and attack position. Can't target yet. What's my targeting range? I don't even fucking know. 23 abouts. Oh, this looks fucking awesome. What is this? What? This shit looks crazy, dude. This, I wish they would include in the normal functionality of the game. These, like, pop-up window things? Awesome. What's my range? Still.
Use your stasis webifier to slow the ship down, and then activate your primary weapons.
You got it! Fire! Fire!
Reinforcements.
How am I destroying this ship?
Keep your web on it and keep firing. We need to destroy that ship.
It's not me. There's... Okay, yeah. So there's a fleet shooting at him as well. There's, like, no way I am destroying a fucking giant capital ship. See, I'm gonna switch to Seekers over here, maybe. Oh, I have to keep my web on this guy. See, that's why I'm fucking bad tackle. I already got distracted. Hey! Fenway Spartan! Yeah! Thanks for the follow, man. Thank you for the follow! We're gonna battle. We're gonna massive battle. Oh. I think I just noticed something wrong. Oh, it's still in shields. Okay. Still in shields. Oh, there we go. Now we're getting some armor damage. This is actually kind of cool.
Officer Fenway Spartan, welcome.
Oh, where are you going? Go back. Why am I just coasting away? Gonna drop my web, he's gonna... Nothing. Should have a point, shouldn't have a web. I get to slow him down, but to slow him down from doing what? From, like, the web would help him warp out faster. So that is another... They do not play this game! People who designed the tutorial are not EVE players. They read a fucking article about it, and that was it. Yeah, this game's awesome, man. This game is awesome. But this tutorial, not accurate. And although it is helpful to new players, I see it a lot more helpful than the previous system. It is very strange the way they touch
Fantastic
on certain things.
Recruit, get back here and start lighting up the hive. We cannot allow it to continue to deploy these seekers any longer.
I'm getting shot.
Fleet, we've breached their defensive perimeter. Scanning the hive now. Pilots, once we have this data, we're burning it down. All forces find a clear shot on the hive.
Holy mama jamma! Ah, fly through it! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Use your afterburner and stop your ship when you reach the hive.
That was hot! I don't know what just happened to me! Wait, what's she saying to me? Locate the hive on your overview and approach it. Locate the hive on my overview and approach it. Bitch, what? Oh, the hive. I was just looking right at it. I'm gonna die!
You should now lock targets and destroy the circadian seekers near the hive.
Oh. Alright, boss. Oh, we got some music change? Weapon fire! Like, a rifter taking out seekers, man, is just beyond my mind. I don't understand. Where are you going? It said approach the hive, but I am... Okay, it's this thing. Oh! So my goal is to destroy these ones. This is crazy. This looks awesome. I don't even know what this is, where I am. This definitely gives you a false pretense as to what the game is like. It's like, do you always see these massive, crazy systems that have humongous NPC battles going on? Maybe that's what they're planning. With the new AI stuff. Like, the Drifter incursions should be in these zones. Fire! That's cool. So, I like it. It is interesting. They've made some interesting choices as far as, like, how... Like, they do not project how much damage certain things do to understand, like, a frigate shooting at a circadian seeker with fucking civilian Gatling guns is not gonna... I don't know. They should be coming back. Drifter incursions? Sativa? Osho. But like, right now, what the fuck? How the fuck? How am I this powerful in a rifter? Oh, snow sucks. Hasn't stopped snowing.
Now it's time to lock your targets on the hive and fire your primary weapons.
Oh. See, I like the idea. Whoa. What is that? See if I can zoom in on it. The fuck is that? It looked like a ship for a second. That's why I can't zoom in anymore. Come here. Am I shooting? Oh. What seasonal thing? Spring? Is that what you mean? Are those drifters or those friendlies? Oh, those are friendlies. Yeah, it's currently snowing right now. Is everybody else shooting at it too? Like, what are they doing? Getting in range, maybe? Am I the only one in range? We did the Blood Angels thing last. Oh, what's next? The Blood Angels, it's the Gala. The Angel and Serpentis Gala.
Literally a factory of death. Bodies go in, machines come out. They've produced thousands of Seekers, and we're building up the capacity to make millions. I'm not saying this is over, but I want you to know your actions have saved countless lives. When this battle is over, and the next begins, it would be an honor to...
Guardians Gala, yep.
Now,
in a world where enemies lie down, lie around every corner, only one pilot can save us all.
I am leaving you with the honor
it is you.
Task of striking the death blow. You have earned it, recruit. This will be the ultimate sacrifice for your comrades. The tribes will remember this moment.
She's asking me to die.
On behalf of the Republic, as of this day, I, Fleet Commander Ina Vardari, promote you to the grade of Naval Capsulea of the Minmatar Republic.
Wait, so I already have a clone?
I grant you full Capsulea privileges under the Uli Convention. You've earned your immortality and independence, Capsulea. It has been
what?
An honor. We could not have eliminated this threat without you. Go with honor, my kin.
She's asking me to die! But how did I... Do I have a clone? Like, I don't understand. Oh, here it goes. Goodbye, crew world. I'll take some of these bitches with me! Take some of you bitches with me! I will not go down without a fight! Ah! Oh, can I warp out? Warp out? I don't know. That's weird, because I'm in my capsule right now. But nobody's potting me. Death is just the beginning. I think... Wait, so now what? Whoa. Okay. Okay.
Congratulations, Captain. You have become an independent Capsulea.
How would a brand new player get involved in this game? I am doing the tutorial right now.
Your mentor would not...
Just sign up, buddy. EVEonline.com!
There is a new mining ship in your redeemable items with the necessary modules to use it successfully for mining operations. There is also a blueprint, so you can rebuild the ship you so nobly sacrificed in...
Oh, man. My wife's calling me.
Before I fully activate the ship to your command...
I'm gonna let Aura talk to you guys for a second.
Hold on. ...with one final suggestion. Go visit the career agents. As you progress so quickly through your training, you may still want to fine-tune your skills. The career agents are also a great way to earn more rewards. It has been a pleasure to guide you through this challenging process, Captain. Fly safe, Capsulea. Click on the highlighted help icon.
I should have put that phone call on fucking speaker because that was so weird. She's like, hey, can you take out frozen meat? Like, she didn't even form a sentence, man. Alright. So we just fucking died. We just died. She just said, alright, for your last test, thank you for contributing your life to the cause. Like, say what? I'm gonna die? I like it, because yeah, you do get that surprise. New player saying, what? What do you mean? And then, oh, capsule ejected. Okay, can't warp out. Well, I don't know how to warp out yet, because they didn't show you. Click on the highlighted Eve help icon, blah, blah, blah. Help. Oh, thank you. Select career agents. And this is where the rest of it begins. Alright.
Each career agent specializes in a certain field. When you've decided which interests you most, set destination to their location.
So let's say exploration is my jam.
The next target,
which it kind of is,
will always have a yellow icon like the one below. Find this gate in the overview.
Oh!
Jump through to move closer to your destination.
Here we go!
You can also activate the autopilot to automatically warp and jump your ship towards your destination. While useful,
thank you. All right.
Autopilot is not as fast as manually traveling from gate to gate.
This is what I was waiting for. Wow, they took a fucking while. Why wasn't this moved to the... I'm sorry, I'm not getting mad. I'm excited. That's great. That's really great. They included this little tidbit about warping. Oh, God, that would have broken my heart. They never mentioned it.
Once you've docked at the career agent station, you can contact them for further instructions. Warp drive active.
So anyways, so this is the tutorial. I'm really glad I took a stab at it. You know, I guess I should be setting a skill queue. Or do the tutorials. I don't intend to do the career agents. I don't know, we'll see. Maybe the next time I log in, I will. But I actually want to try and fly around in my comet and maybe get a kill or a fight at least. So we'll get to the station that we're supposed to get to. It was kind of buggy the way that... Camera has always been my... I don't know. Camera's always been my enemy. I lost that beautiful rifter, man. What's that noise? I know, it was so weird starting over. Like, what would I do? I would do the tutorial. I would do all the career agents, definitely. If this was me in brand new Baby Eve mode. Because they're good. They are good. And you get ships and shit, you get skills and modules. You understand things a little bit. Quicka. $89,000 ISK. So we're dock.
Warp drive active.
And I like how they kind of emphasize a little bit on how there's different icons for things in your overview. That's good. I don't know. Improvements could be made. Improvements could be made.
Permission requested. Docking request accepted.
I hate that. I hate that the radio menu keeps popping up.
Find the career agent you are interested in working with in the agent section of the station services and start a conversation with them.
Exploration.
Cosmic anomalies.
The career agent has offered you a mission. Accept it, and you will begin your chosen career path. You are now in the good hands of the career agents. I suggest exploring different careers with their guidance. I will now enter standard operations mode as your ship's AI.
Oh shit, bye Aura! That's it! That's the last you hear from Aura. Yeah. Alright, I'm not gonna... Actually, do I have a timer on this? Within 6 hours, yeah, so I'm not going to accept it right now. That was really cool.
The drifters are real, man. The drifters are a fucking issue. I don't know when we'll see that story unfold. In Eve itself, like outside of this tutorial, like I hope the Drifter invasions are still in the works to come back. Incursions is what I meant to say. Cause it's a very interesting story. Like they're the offspring. No, they're not the offspring. They're like a separate entity from the Jove Sleepers. Very cool. I love this game, guys. EVE Online. I was going to go to FanFest this year. I was going to try, but I really can't afford it. Real life. I could start a fucking... That would be some dope shit if I could start a fund to try and get to FanFest via Twitch. That is a fucking amazing idea. That's the only way. Like, I'm not going to work myself into the ground. Streaming is the fun. Streaming is the good fun. That would be cool if I was able to do it. Maybe I'll start that tomorrow. But for now, let's switch gears. Let's switch gears, hairs. Loglight, thank you. Thank you, Loglight. So, we're switching to my main character in EVE Online. His name is Nicola. Nicola Armand. And he's a bit strange. But before we get into this, let me get a drink. Let me use the bathroom. I suggest you all do the same. I suggest everyone kind of gets up, gets a little stretch. We'll be back in like a minute, not even 45 seconds. I wasn't gone long. Oh, but let's put our image up. And let's get into it. Let's get into the nitty-gritty. I like to fly comets. I specifically like to fly Galente. And I fly other ships as well. I am skilled in all frigate ships. I'm rusty, as all fucking fuck, and I would like to break that. Very rusty. He can dock easily. And he has. So, as I said, I'm very fucking rusty. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. But hopefully, with your help, we will get there. Well, let's move this down so you can see my... You can see my... timers, at least. I got no problem with timers.
I got no qualms with them.
Can't really see. Here we go. Synesis! No, thank you. Actually, fuck it, let's see. I like to fight. I'm not scared. Oh, we got a little bit of lag, though. That's not good. Kilometers. Whoa. Oh no. I think I'm having lag. I think I'm having lag! Wow! Yeah, some stuff is resetting. Let me fix, guys. There we go. Tristan A. Fast Tristan is not good. Oh, no, he's not even participating. The Synesis is just doing what? Baiting me? Fuck. I don't understand what's going on here. Just taken into the face right now. I don't know why. Oh, I'm getting lag or something. Docked up. I don't get why he's taking that damage, though. But I am getting some weird lag. Guys, let me know if something fucking weird happens to the stream. No me gusta. Usually that means it's time to take a real break. It should be good, though. Synesis is back. I don't get what he's doing, though. Nothing. There is a point where he... will be kind of far. Let's go. Let's see what he reacts. How he reacts. What does he got for guns? He's got rockets. So... oh, he's warping. Warping where, though? Sun? Look like a sun warp. Look like a sun warp to me. Turn auto-reload off, everybody. Remember to fucking do that. Auto-reload off. Don't be that guy. I'm always that guy. I hate being that guy. Sip of juice. It is. It is a sun warp. Sun catcher right here. He's right on me. Oh my god, we have him. Web scrammed. Web disrupted. Gonna overheat my afterburner. Have to. Kinda have to. I don't know if he's got a micro warp drive. Okay, I'm gonna stop overheating my shit so it doesn't all burn out. Guns can probably stay. He's getting out of range, of course he is. Always happens to me. I don't know how I let that happen, though. Get him, get him, get him. There we go. I was gonna say, am I getting lag for reals? I'm overheating my shit, though! Giving him time to think. I told you guys, I'm rusty. Ugh, I am getting lag. Because I'm reacting so slow. Yeah, my ship. Well, we're gonna fight the internet now, baby. Forgot about my Hobbs. I fucked up. Fucked up cuz forgot about my drones. One. Oh. What a bad fucking move, dude. What a bad move. Oh, it makes me so sad. Oh, that was my fucking... Like, I caught him at the sun. That was not his win. That was my win. And I fucked it up. Oh, I hate being such a scrub. Let's go back and grab another one of those biddies. Oh, opportunity wasted, friends. That is the name of the game. Oh, opportunity wasted. Salute. Let's put him on the stream. Oh, well, we'll get through it. You live and you learn. I always forget something, and I... Sometimes chat helps me, like, chat will yell, and I'll see it. For some reason, I'll just tunnel on my movement, and I'll forget about unloading all of my weaponry, and keeping an eye on it. Like drones, you have to babysit a little bit. You have to, like, fucking... commit your mind to different things. Not tunnel vision. I love this ship though. I love the Comet. Especially in this iteration of it. Like, I love Rail Comet. Yeah, I'm getting some issues with connections, guys. Modem looks alright. What time is it? 11. Yeah, we're just gonna endlessly warp. So let's just chill. Let's chill. Chit chat a little bit about what we're gonna do the next time we stream. I think I want to play some Siege. Whoa, we're getting buggy shit. I think the servers are getting fucked up. Oh yeah, unresponsive game. Alright, we're gonna cut it. We're gonna just reset my internet, maybe. No, because other things are working. I don't know. Is the game fucking crashing? Wow, look at these long warps. Ah. Alright. I have to do it, guys. I'll reset. But yeah, the only streamer I have followed right now is Viper. So I'm gonna host Viper back. How do I do that? Where am I? There I am. Yeah, I'm having connection issues, so I'm gonna reset. And I'll take this time to go to practice. I've got to band practice, I've got to go. I was just gonna cut it at 12, but I'm like sitting in really long warps. And I was fighting this Synesis, this guy. And I was definitely like lagging the fuck out. He fucked me up. I did make a stupid mistake at the end, but the lag, like, was very confusing, very unresponsive. So I'm gonna give my internet a cooldown. So my, I don't know, everything looks fine. But why am I getting Eve issues? And I'm looking through help chat, because usually they start spamming, "Oh my god, lag! What's happening to the game? The game's breaking!" But nobody seems to notice. Or be complaining. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Yeah, see? Look at this long-ass warp. What the fuck is this? Is the game broken? Is it broken? It's too long. That's silly. Look at my overview's not even loading. Yeah. I don't know. Something's fucked up.
Warp drive active.
But yeah, we'll be back. What day's today? Today's Monday. What is going on later today? Should be able to come back later. Because I still want to set up a few things. Set up a few things. Well, I made it to my destination, but let's see how long this warp is. And go! Like, what is this? What the fuck?
Warp drive active.
Anyways. If we're not back tonight, we're definitely gonna be back tomorrow night. I might just be able to watch Twitch. I don't think I'll be able to stream later, unless it's late in the night. But yeah, guys, that was really cool. We did the EVE Online tutorial. First time ever. Got a fucking eye-opening experience about how new players come to this game. Wow. I don't know. I liked it. And didn't like it in different ways. And in different measurements. But I definitely think it's a good addition to the game. I think so. I think it's better than what we had. Go CCP. But I'll be back later. Let's see if my host Viper will work. And stay safe, everybody. Stay cool. Next time we log into EVE, we will fly this. Oh yeah, look at this lag. Oh my god. It's not even loading my ship. Oh my god, is my computer breaking? Maybe. We'll be back later. Salute. Salutations. God bless you.